Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the best multiple choice questions from the first week of January 2017. So new year, new hopes and new MCQs. And I have covered 150 questions. So that shows that the number of questions this week was very high. And therefore, it is very important. Another thing worth noting is that since this is the, you know, this week is the first week. So there is a lot of analysis from the last, last week. Of December, because in last week of December we have a lot of these reports coming up, so the factual questions this week are more, so that you have to keep in mind, and therefore these questions become important automatically. Now you can follow me on Facebook, www.facebook.com/gauravgargeducation. This is the URL that you have to type. You can get this in the description also. And we have launched the pen drive for IBPS and SBI, PO and Clerk both for 2017. If you want to buy any of our pen drive courses, you need to dial this number 958-004-8004. Now we also provide two brand new fresh videos every week. That is only for the pen drive holders. So without further delay, let me begin. The world's tallest solar tower. The world's tallest solar tower, it is 250 meters tall. And you can guess the height, because the Qutub Minar is 72 meters tall. So this is like 3.5 times more than the height of Qutub Minar. It is the world's largest, tallest solar tower. It is being constructed in Negev Desert. In which country? So if you know in which country Negev Desert is there, then this is an easy question. So Negev Desert is in Israel. And Israel's head of state is Benjamin Netanyahu. That you must know. Who is Benjamin Netanyahu? Israel has been in news because of the passing of United Nations Security Council sanctions, as Israel was building up establishments in the Palestinian region. And also Israel is often accused of human rights violations in the Palestinian occupations. And Israel's capital is Jerusalem. According to the Central Statistical Office, that is CSO. In exam, you might not get Central Statistical Office, but CSO in short. According to CSO data, what is estimated to be India's GDP growth in 2016-2017, that is from 1st April 2016 to 31st March 2017, also called financial year 2017. So India's growth will be 7.1% according to the Central Statistical Office. And last year India's growth was 7.6%. So this time we are losing by 0.5% because of demonetization. Which tennis player won the Qatar Open title, beating Andy Murray in the final? Now Andy Murray has been on song. Andy Murray, he is world number one right now. He is from Britain. Now you know Britain has three countries, that is Scotland, Wales and England. So he is from Scotland. And he is world number one. So Qatar Open, but he could not win. He was beaten by ex-world number one, that is Novak Djokovic, the great player. And Novak Djokovic is from Serbia. Kai Nishikori is Japanese player. Rafael Nadal is a Spanish player, very popular for winning French Open 9 times. And Roger Federer, of course, is the Switzerland greatest player of all time because he has won 17 Grand Slams. Sania Mirza won her first doubles title of 2017, that is the Brisbane International Women's Double title. Whom did she pair up with? So this is a good question. So Sania Mirza has won her first title of the year 2017 very, very soon, that is in the first week of January itself, and she has won the Brisbane International women's double title. So she paired up with Bethany Mathaxand, and Bethany Mathaxand is from America, and may their pair go long way. B Strikova was the previous partner of Sania Mirza, that is before Bethany Mathaxand, and B Strikova, Sania has also won a few titles with her, and B Strikova is from Czech, you know. Martina Hingis and Sania Mirza, they have had a great pairing. They won a lot of Grand Slams, and Martina Hingis was from Switzerland. So these are the three important partners of Sania Mirza that you should know. Castrol has entered into a three-year strategic partnership agreement for supply of commercial vehicle oil to which company? And this agreement is huge. It's a big agreement because this car company or motor company and Castrol, they will have this partnership in more than 50 countries, more than 50 markets. So Castrol has entered into this strategic partnership agreement with Tata Motors. Reserve Bank of India, which is the Central Bank of India, And there is a central bank of Nepal, which is called Nepal Rashtra Bank. Just like we have RBI, Nepal has Nepal Rashtra Bank. So Reserve Bank of India has decided to provide 1 billion, that is 100 crore rupees, in which denomination notes to Nepal Rashtra Bank. That is because Nepal Rashtra Bank, in Nepal, there is a huge shortage of this denomination. It is rupees 100. So rupee 100 denomination notes, total 100 crore rupees will be provided to Nepal by Reserve Bank of India. And again, an important question. Total Reserve Bank of India provides 600 crore rupees, that is 6 billion rupees every year to Nepal Rashtra Bank. SEBI, the market regulator, market watchdog, Securities and Exchange Board of India, it has relaxed its rules for investing by angel investors to boost startup funding. What is the new lock-in period? Okay, so I need to give you some concepts here. See, who is an angel investor? Let's say you start a company. So in the initial stages, you will run it with your own money. That is called bootstrap. These are some MBA jargons that I learned during MBA. Then bootstrap, now you will need funding to expand the company. So you want to raise money and you will dilute some equity. That is, some part of your company will be, occupied by the investor. So that is an angel investor who funds around. There is no definition that there is no demarcation line that here angel investors end and here venture capitalist starts. But typically angel investors invest something around 5 to 10 crore rupees at max. And after that, if you want to, let's say you want to hire big, you want to raise more money, let's say 50 crore, 100 crore, then you will need a venture capitalist. Venture capitalist can be an individual person, it can be a group of person, it can be a group of companies, it can be a single company. So what has happened is to boost startups. Startups means new businesses. India desperately needs new businesses, and these businesses need to be funded. So because businesses are not sustainable in the initial phases, especially when they want to expand. So SEBI has relaxed its rules and now the lock-in period is 1 year. Earlier it was 3 years. So they have decreased it by 2 years. And please note that lock-in period is the period during which you cannot withdraw the money. That is the lock-in period. Another important thing. SEBI, earlier angel investors had to invest a minimum of 50 lakh rupees. Now that has also been decreased to 25 lakh. And this is to attract investments from angel investors. So 25 lakh now and for 1 year. Next question. Nana Akufo-Addo. So Nana Akufo-Addo, he has been sworn in as the new president of which African country? And the capital of this African country is Accra. So now can you guess the answer? Yes, it is Ghana. So Nana Akufo-Addo, he is the new president of Ghana. And he represents NPP, that is the New Patriotic Party. The Islamic Military Alliance to Fight Terrorism has been appointed whom as their new chief. So Islamic Military Alliance has a lot of countries. They have all the Muslim countries, and total number of countries in Islamic Military Alliance to Fight Terrorism, IMAFT, is 39. 39 Muslim countries are there which have vowed to fight terror, and they have appointed Rahil Sharif as their chief. And Rahil Sharif is the ex-chief of army staff of Pakistan. Now it is Kamar Bajwa, but previously Rahil Sharif was there. He retired in November. The 9th edition of Jaipur International Film Festival, it has presented a lifetime achievement award to which famous person? So it is Jaipur International Film Festival. Please note, it is not Jaipur Literary Festival, which is the largest literary festival in India. It is Jaipur International Film Festival, and it was conducted for the 9th time. And it presented Mr. Ramesh Prasad with the Lifetime Achievement Award because Mr. Ramesh Prasad has created specialized post-production facilities and advanced equipment for cinema. Who has been made the General Secretary of the AIADMK party? All India Anna Dravid Munnetra Kazhagam is the party from Tamil Nadu, and after the untimely demise of Selvi Jayalalitha, they wanted to have a new General Secretary. Chief Minister is Mr. O. Panir Selvam, but the General Secretary is now Shashikala, the long-time friend of Jayalalitha. And this is said to be a strategic maneuver because Jayalalitha had that, woman connect. So Shashikala also has that connect. And it is being said that she will very soon be projected as the face of the party. So she might in fact overtake Mr. O. Panir Selvam as the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. So let's see how the situation unfolds. Which Indian force will make their debut in the Republic Parade in 2017 for the first time ever showcasing their anti-terror, anti-hijacking and special operations capabilities. So which Indian force will make their debut for the first time ever? It is the National Security Guard. This time in parade on 26 Jan. Do check out, National Security Guard will be there. And another important thing, there can be four questions that can be asked from Republic Day. First, who is the chief guest? So chief guest is the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi. Abu Dhabi is the capital of UAE, United Arab Emirates. And Crown Prince is Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan. I repeat, Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan is the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi. And he is our chief guest this time. And also not that since he is from UAE, so UAE Army can also be paraded. UAE Army has been invited by our official ministry, concerned department. And if they ask you the question, you know who or which country's military was the first foreign country I'm talking about to be paraded at the Republic Parade? It was French. French Army had participated, if you remember, in 2016 Republic Day Parade, and it became the first ever foreign army to participate in the Republic Day Parade. So these are some of the questions that can be put up from the Republic Day Parade. French Army was the first ever. Which country's army has issued a notice or a directive on grooming and appearance regulations that allow the observant Sikh men and conservative Muslim women to wear religious head coverings, also permitting Sikh soldiers to maintain their beard? So there were a lot of issues here, but this country's army has finally woken up to the fact that religious faiths are important, and Sikh men, they can wear their turban, they can keep long beard as per their religion, and so with the Muslim women. Both Sikh and Muslim are in minority in this country. This country is United States of America. It has now permitted Sikh men and Muslim women to follow their faith practices, which were said to be against the army rules earlier on. ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization, it will send how many satellites, you know, at one go in February 2017, and they will launch these satellites from Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota in Andhra Pradesh. Now, no country has even attempted to launch these many satellites together in one go. So ISRO headquarters is in Bengaluru, and it has decided to launch 103 satellites in one go. And this they will launch in the first week of February 2017 from their rocket PSLV. PSLV is super important. PSLV C-37 they call it the workhorse. That is, it is very frequently used to launch satellites. And similarly, there is a rocket of China also, Long March, which China has been using for launching its own satellites, like remote sensing satellites and so on. Which country has become the first country in the world to switch off its FM radio? FM means frequency modulation. So like in India, you have a lot of FM like 99.4 and 98.3 and all that. So frequency modulation is called FM. So which country has become the first country in the world to switch off its FM radio network? Because it has digitized it. So now you can listen to the network in a digital way using digital audio broadcasting. That is called DAB. So it has completely digitized its FM. So this country is Norway. It's a Scandinavian country, and Norway capital is Oslo. Norway is popular because of one person, that is Magnus Carlsen, who is 3 times chess world champion. Chess. Sweden capital is Stockholm. Finland capital is Helsinki. Denmark capital is Copenhagen. These are all Scandinavian countries where the human development index is very high. Rich countries, very attractive lifestyle. According to scientists, you know that Antarctica, there is all ice. So from Antarctica, there is a huge iceberg which will be separated. And this is the greatest iceberg to detach itself from Antarctica, largest ever recorded. And it is not because of climate change. So there is a relief. It is not because of climate change, but because there was a rift. You know, there was a rift, just like in a wall, we have a rift. It keeps on increasing in size, and finally the two walls separate. Similarly here, this ice piece in Antarctica, it will break because of the rift. And what is the dimension? That is, what is the dimension of this iceberg that will break away from Antarctica? It is 5,000 square kilometer. So it's a huge, the largest ever recorded iceberg that will break away. Our cabinet has given in principle approval for strategic disinvestment of 26% equity shares in which company out of the government shareholding of 54%, becoming the first PSU in India to be sold through strategic disinvestment. So I remember during the time of Congress, there was a Vijay Kelkar committee which had also recommended disinvestment. That is, you disinvest in the PSUs and raise capital to decrease the fiscal deficit. Now, something similar BJP is doing. So in this company, government has a 54% stake. 54% equity is there. Now it is diluting its equity by 28%. So the government's equity will remain only 26%. But there is a private company which owns more than 26%. Therefore, the owner is no longer the government. It is the private company. That is what you call transfer of ownership through strategic disinvestment. And this the government has done in BEML, Bharat Earth Movers Limited. And please note, BEML is the first company, first major PSU to be sold through strategic disinvestment. Employees Provident Fund Organization, that is EPFO, which is responsible for pensions and various benefits associated with pension. So Employees Provident Fund Organization has made what thing mandatory for its pensioners. And if they want to remain beneficiaries of the social security schemes that are associated with the pension. And also if they want that their subsidy, which is 1.16% of their salary up to ₹6,500. If they want this, then they have to give their what? They have to link their account to what? So they have to link their account to Aadhaar. Very important. And please note the deadline is 31st January 2017. That is, whoever is a beneficiary of the pension will have to submit, will have to link his account to Aadhaar. Otherwise, he will not avail the benefit of 1.16% of the salary benefit up to ₹6,500. So that is very important. And deadline is 31st Jan 2017. Indian citizens who are not living in India, that is temporary outside, which are called NRIs, Apravasi Bhartiya. So NRIs have been allowed to exchange the demonetized 500 and 1000 rupee notes if they possess it at Reserve Bank of India offices. What is the deadline that Reserve Bank of India has given for the NRIs? That is, till what date NRIs can exchange their demonetized notes. So it is 30 June 2017. That is the deadline. So from 1st July onwards, if they hold any money, it will be invalid. Which telecom company? So you know that telecom company in India is an oligopolistic market. There are very few players. There is Vodafone, Airtel, Jio, BSNL, Aircel, Idea and all that. Very few companies. So which telecom company in India has announced a super hour scheme? So there is an hour, 1 hour, during which you can download unlimited data if you pay ₹16 or you can, using 3G, 4G, or you can have unlimited call in this 1 hour. You have to pay only ₹7. This super hour scheme has been started by Vodafone. IRCTC, which is Indian Railways Catering and Tourism Corporation Limited, it is launching which ticket app? So IRCTC is launching which ticket app, and it will be based on the next generation e-ticketing system to facilitate booking of train tickets in a faster and easier way. And this is basically, they have updated their old app and now their new app is IRCTC Rail Connect. IRCTC Rail Connect, you can download this app and you can book your tickets very, very fast in a transparent manner and using digital transaction. Chinese mobile companies, Chinese mobile brands. Now, which are the Chinese mobile brands that are operating in India right now? Four are main. One is Lenovo, one is Oppo, one is OnePlus, and the fourth is Xiaomi. These are the four Chinese mobile companies which have completely overtaken the Indian market. So, what was their control? What percentage of control did they have in the Indian smartphone market in 2016? And Indian smartphone market is valued at $10 billion, which is 67,000 crore. So out of 67,000 crore, 33,000 crore or more is occupied by Chinese brands. So 50%. 50% Indian market is now occupied by Chinese mobile phones. And the biggest loser is Samsung. In 2015, Chinese brands had only 16% of Indian smartphone market share. Look, 34% increase. And people say that we have boycotted Chinese products. The world's second largest zinc producer, which is called Hindustan Zinc Limited of the Vedanta Group, it has received the environment clearance for its ₹200 crore. That is the outlay of the project, ₹200 crore. It is called Zawar Mines Expansion Project. And Zawar Mines, you know, it is the second largest, you know, it is made by Hindustan Zinc Limited, which is the second largest zinc producer in the world. So this Zawar Mines Expansion Project is being built in which state? It is being built with an outlay of ₹1200 crore in Rajasthan, which is a BJP government. Capital is the pink city, Jaipur, and Chief Minister is Vasundhara Raje Sindhya of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Which state government has announced a monetary reward of ₹100 crore to anyone from the state government who wins the Nobel Prize aimed at boosting the innovation? So this is a good step. The scientist or anyone who from this state, if he wins a Nobel Prize, he will get 100 crore rupees. and this was announced by Chief Minister Chandra Babu Naidu. It's out of the box idea, and maybe because of the monetary benefit, someone really innovates. So it was announced by the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Chandra Babu Naidu, who is from the Telugu Desam Party, and the language, as we all know, is Telugu, state language. Who was named the captain of Indian one-day T20 team because of the stepping down of MS Dhoni? So MS Dhoni resigned as the captain of the Indian cricket team in one-day and test matches in T20. In test matches, we already had Virat Kohli as the captain. Now he is the Indian captain in all the three formats. So the answer is Virat Kohli. And it is being rumored that Virat Kohli will very soon marry his long-time girlfriend Anushka Sharma the engagement will take place in Dehradun. So I read this in, I think, 2-3 newspapers. So America's first lady. First lady, we say to the wife of the president. So US president is right now Barack Obama till 20th of January. From 21st of January, Donald Trump will take over. And then the first lady will be the wife of Donald Trump. So the first question for today, what is the name of the wife of Donald Trump? That is your first question for today. Now, US First Lady Michelle Obama, she has picked which 16-year-old Indian-American to serve in the inaugural Student Advisory Board's Better Make Room campaign. It's an educational campaign, and for this, one Indian-American girl has been picked up by Michelle Obama for her campaign, and she is a part of the Student Advisory Board. Her name is Shweta Prabhakaran. Shweta Prabhakaran. The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, also called popularly as NASA. NASA's headquarters is in Washington, D.C., capital of America. National Aeronautics and Space Administration is sending which African-American astronaut to the International Space Station in 2018? And it has become the first African-American to go into the space station. So, the first African-American to go to space will be Janet Apps in 2018, as decided by NASA. Who has been appointed as the new chairman of the Union Public Service Commission, UPSC. So UPSC chairman was Alka Sirohi. Alka Sirohi, who had taken over from Mr. Gupta. So Alka Sirohi has now, her tenure is over. And now the new appointment is David Siamlia. David Siamlia. And please note that UPSC chairman cannot serve for a second time at the same position. So there are a lot of posts in India where you cannot serve two times. So UPSC chairman cannot be the chairman of UPSC again. So David Siamlia is the new chairman appointed by the President of India. Who became the first batsman in the world ever to score in the history of cricket test match 100 in 11 countries of the world? So he has scored century in 11 countries of the world. His name is Yunus Khan from Pakistan. Great cricketer, 39 years old, but still very active, still very fit and playing very good. So, playing very well. So, Yunus Khan is the answer from Pakistan. He has become the first batsman to score test match 100 in 11 countries of the world. Which Indian tennis player announced his retirement recently? Because for a long time he had been suffering from shoulder injury. And so, he decided to hang up his boots. His name is Somdev Devaraman. And Somdev had made waves during his match with Rafael Nadal. I remember even in Wimbledon he had qualified as a wild card entry. And he tried his best. But it wasn't to be, and now he has taken retirement. Another tennis player has retired. Her name is Ana Ivanovic. If you remember, I told you in the last video, Ana Ivanovic from Serbia. She also retired. She was a French Open winner. She had beaten Dinara Safina, then world number one to win that Grand Slam. And Ana Ivanovic was from Serbia. Ana Ivanovic's husband is Bastian Schweinsteiger, who plays for Germany and Manchester United Football Club. And he's also a great midfielder. So these all things you should know. Which Indian-American has been appointed by the US President-elect? Who will be POTUS, that is President of the United States, on 21st of January 2017? Donald Trump has appointed which Indian person for his post as Deputy Assistant and Research Director on the White House staff? So his name is Raj Shah. Very important. And other Donald Trump appointments are equally important, like Colonel James Mattis, Rex Tillerson. So you should be very, very thorough with the Donald Trump cabinet. Which company has been awarded a patent for setting up an airborne fulfillment center floating at a high altitude that would act as a launch pad for drones to deliver items within minutes? So please understand, what is this? So, you know, in the sky, just like godowns are there, you know, on our planet Earth, similarly, there will be godowns in the sky, which will be called airborne fulfillment center, where this company will store its goods, and from there the drones will pick up these goods and they will deliver to the doorsteps. So this much innovation this company is ahead of its peers. It is of course Amazon, and Amazon's founder is Jeff Bezos, one of the richest guys in the world, in top four in the world. Scientists in the University of Limerick have discovered a brand new organ which is called mesentery. So inside the digestive system, which was not known till date. So this is very, very surprising. So just in the your digestive system, you have all these components. It starts from your mouth, oral cavity, and it ends till anus. So digestive system, there is something known as small intestine, large intestine. So in the small intestine, there is a part called mesentery, which was not known to the scientists till now. It was recently discovered by the scientist in the University of Limerick. Where is this University of Limerick? So it is in Ireland, and Ireland's capital is Dublin. Who beat Magnus Carlsen in a tiebreaker to win the gold medal in the World Blitz Chess Championship? So Blitz is a format of chess where you don't get too much time to think. You just have to move, and it will depend on your lot of skills. Like you can think fast, etc. Vishwanathan Anand is known to think very fast. That is why he is called the Lightning Kid in the chess ecosystem. So who beat Magnus Carlsen? So basically he took his revenge, because Magnus Carlsen in the World Chess Championship beat him. Sergey Karyakin of Russia, who was born in Ukraine. Sergey Karyakin was beaten by Magnus Carlsen in the World Chess Championship, but in the World Blitz Chess Championship, Sergey Karyakin beat Magnus Carlsen. Magnus Carlsen, as I said, is from Norway. Sergey Karyakin is Russian. Fabio Caruana is another great player. He is from Italy. Gang Mumei Kabui passed away recently. What was he famous as? So Gang Mumei Kabui, what was he famous as? So question related to obituary, and this week there are at least 10 obituaries. So he was a renowned historian, but in the option you might not get historian because he was a politician also. So he was a politician, and he was one of the founders and president of the Federal Party of Manipur. They might also ask you, where did he hail from? So he was from Manipur, same place where Mary Kom hails from. Which country's women football team won their fourth consecutive SAF Women's Championship title in the finals of the Kanchenjunga Stadium in Siliguri? Kanchenjunga, it is the highest peak, Himalayan peak in India. Height is 8,598 meter, and it is in Sikkim. Everybody knows it is a part of the Great Himalayas. So which country's women team, football team, won the fourth consecutive SAF Women's Championship? This was done by the Indian team. So Indian women's football team made us proud for the fourth time in a row. Mahinder Singh Dhoni recently stepped down. He resigned as the captain of all the three formats. So how many test matches, one day matches, and T20 matches did he captain? Very, very important. So overall he captained 60 test matches, 199 one day matches, and 72 T20 matches. So the answer is A, and this might be asked in some of the exams. NDMC, which is the New Delhi Municipal Council, it has appointed which person as the brand ambassador for its Swachh NDMC initiative? Another important question. Two people have been appointed as the brand ambassador, not one. So one is Deepa Malik. Yes, Deepa Malik, you know, the Paralympian who had won the silver medal in the Paralympics in Rio de Janeiro. And Arunima Sinha, she is a ex-national volleyball player who was thrown out of the train. Her leg had to be cut, but she did not lose heart. She in fact climbed Mount Everest 2 times, and she has written a book called Born Again on the Mountain. Do check that out. It is one of my favorite books, and also I recommend these books to students. Never lose hope. Her legs had to be cut off, but she did not lose heart, and now she has scaled all the highest peaks in the world, including Mount Everest, which is the highest in the world, with an average height of 8,848 meters. So Arunima Sinha and Deepa Malik, they both have been made the brand ambassador for NDMC Swachh initiative. And Sakshi Malik, we all know, she recently got married, and she got married to her long time beau, Mr. Kadyan. And Sakshi Malik is a bronze medalist in wrestling in Olympics. Who has been conferred the Power and Energy Personas Award for Individual Excellence at the 10th Anarshia Awards 2016. So this person is also the chairman of NHPC. NHPC is one of our renewable energy initiatives, that is National Hydroelectric Power Corporation. National Hydroelectric Power Corporation, and you know hydropower is a renewable source of energy. So this person is KM Singh, and he has been chosen for Power and Energy Personas Award for Individual Excellence at the 10th Anarshia Awards. NHPC chairman is KM Singh. The world famous Bargad Dhanua Jatra Festival, it has started in which state of India? The government in this state is BJD, Biju Janata Dal. The chief minister is Naveen Patnaik. So the world famous Bargad Dhanua Jatra festival has started in Odisha. Very, very important festival. It is the world's largest. It is also the world's largest open air theatrical festival. Which Indian origin Saudi based entrepreneur businessman has been appointed Major General of Kyrgyzstan by Ali Mirza, who is the defense minister of Kyrgyzstan? So Kyrgyzstan, the Central Asian country, Kyrgyzstan, Uzbekistan, you know, all these Kazakhstan and all these countries. So which Indian origin, he's an Indian origin person. His name is Sheikh Rafiq Muhammad, and he's an entrepreneur, businessman. He has been appointed as the Major General of Kyrgyzstan. So the answer is Sheikh Rafiq Muhammad. Which country announced a plan to ban all the ivory? So elephant teeth are called ivory, and there is a huge smuggling. There is a huge smuggling of ivory, and for that, a lot of animals are killed. They are poached. Elephant poaching is very rampant in Africa, like in Kruger National Park and all these parks. So a lot of elephants are killed, and which has made their survival very difficult. So which country has announced to ban ivory trade? The deadline is 2017 end. It is China. Who launched an intellectual property rights enforcement toolkit for police along with an IPR awareness campaign for school children? Now, intellectual property rights, intellectual property is your own creation. It can be a song, it can be anything basically. Even this video which I am preparing is my intellectual property. So IPR enforcement toolkit for police and the IPR awareness, it was launched by our Union Minister for Commerce, Nirmala Sitharaman. Nirmala Sitharaman, Union Minister for Commerce and Industry. Robert Marchand, he is a 105-year-old man, and he has made a record. That is, he did a cycling of 22.5 kilometer, that is almost 14 miles in 1 hour. So this he did at Saint-Colin-en-Uil in Paris. So he is from which country? So he is from Paris itself. He is from France actually. And he made a record. He is 105 years old and 22.5 kilometer in just 1 hour. Next, Abdul Halim Zafar. He died recently. He was a very, very famous musician. In fact, he was one of the top three, as agreed upon by most people, that there are three people who are at the pinnacle of sitar. So he played sitar. So along with these three people who are the most popular in sitar, Pandit Ravi Shankar, who is now no more, but his daughter Anushka Shankar is very active, Ustad Vilayat Khan and Abdul Halim Zafar. These three are three of the greatest in India. In fact, he had his own way of playing sitar, which was called the Zafar Khani Baz, after his name, Zafar Khani Baz. There is a book about the life of APJ Abdul Kalam, which is called, the book's name is The People's President, APJ Abdul Kalam. It was released by our Honorable Vice President Shri Hamid Ansari. So it has been written by whom? Who has written the book APJ, The People's President APJ Abdul Kalam? This book is written by S.M. Khan, who was a press secretary at the time of when the President Kalam was there. Which Disney artist, cartoonist? So he's basically world famous cartoonist. He's a Disney artist. That is, he's very famous for his Walt Disney cartoon character called Bambi. Remember this name, Bambi. So he recently expired. He died, and his rise to fame was Bambi, Walt Disney animated feature. His name is Tyrus Wong. America, this is a bad news for Pakistan. America has designated Al Muhammadiyah as a terror organization. It has declared Al Muhammadiyah, and Al Muhammadiyah is basically a student's body of which bigger terror organization? Al Muhammadiyah students, it is a terrorist organization. It has been declared as a terrorist organization by America, and it is a branch of students branch of Lashkar-e-Taiba. Which government bank, public sector bank, has announced a partnership with CNX Corporation? CNX Corporation, which public sector bank has partnered with CNX Corporation? Together they will provide collateral management services. Collateral is when you take loan and you put something in the bank, that is called collateral. So collateral management services, especially for farmers' benefit, will be provided by CNX Corporation in association with Bank of Baroda. So Bank of Baroda is the answer. What is the name of the missile which India successfully conducted its test firing from the Abdul Kalam Island in Odisha? Please note, Abdul Kalam Island is also called Wheeler Island. Wheeler Island in Odisha, and the name of the missile which India successfully test fired and it is a Agni 4. And please also note that Agni 4, its range is 4000 km. It is a surface to surface missile. It is a ballistic missile. So these all things you should know. What is the name of the mobile app that is launched by the Maritime Union of India? And Maritime Union of India has been representing Indian Merchant Navy since 1939. So they also have planned to go digital. And the name of their app is in fact the abbreviation of Maritime Union of India, which is MUI. Which court in India has said that no politician in India can seek votes, can ask for votes in the name of caste, language or religion? It has been declared unconstitutional and severe action will be taken, and it is been declared as a corrupt practice and not permissible under law. So this is a historic judgment. It is passed by seven judges, and the seven judges were presided over by the ex-Chief Justice of India, T.S. Thakur. Now, of course, the Chief Justice is Mr. Keher. So this announcement was made by the Supreme Court of India, the apex court. Which country has delivered four Sukhoi Su-35 fighter jets to China? Very, very powerful. In fact, this country also provides India a lot of arms and ammunition and weapons, advanced weapons. It gave India Sukhoi Su-30. But China, it has given even more powerful. This country is, of course, India's all-weather friend, Russia. Who has been awarded the Scroll of Honor? He's an IAS officer, he's a district collector, and he has done seminal work in promoting cashless transactions in his district. And for that, a person no less than the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, gave him a Scroll of Honor. So he's an IAS officer. His name is Gaurav Goyal. So I share my name with him, but I don't know when I'll get an award, if at all. So Gaurav Goyal, and he's a district collector of Ajmer in Rajasthan. Ajmer, popularly known for Moinuddin Chishti Dargah. Who is the Union Minister of State, that is MOS, with independent charge for minorities? And why was he in news? He was in news because he recently launched a Haj Committee of India mobile app, because to bring transparency in the online applications to ensure fair opportunity for everyone, because there are a lot of applications to do Haj, but only a few are selected by the government. So there has to be transparency, and for that is a mobile app now launched by this minister. His name is Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. Previously, Najma Abdullah was the Minorities Affairs Minister, but she resigned. Who was appointed to take over as the Vice Chief of Air Staff at the Air Headquarters, Vayu Bhavan? Who was appointed to take over as Vice Chief of Air Staff? So this gentleman is very, he has won a lot of awards. His name is S.B. Deo. Very, very brave, courageous. He has won Ati Vishisht Seva Medal, Vayu Sena Medal, Param Vishisht Seva Medal, ADC. All these awards have been won, and now he is the Vice Chief of Air Staff as appointed by the President. China's Grand Slam champion, Li Zhaoxia, she had a more than 20 years career in this sport. She won whatnot. She won all the Grand Slams. Then she won the Olympic gold medal in doubles. So which sport did she play? China's Grand Slam champion, Li Zhaoxia, one of the best known players on planet for this sport, table tennis. Table tennis is also called ping pong. India recently held ministerial level talks between the Indian Minister for Agriculture, who is Radha Mohan Singh, and Minister of Fisheries of this particular country to discuss the fisherman issue. So this fisherman issue with this country has been since time immemorial. So basically our fishermen go to their side of the ocean, their fishermen come to our side of the ocean. So our coast guard and all, they take them into, they arrest them. And then there is this fisherman issue. So now all the fishermen that India had caught of this country, and this country which it had caught of ours, have been released. And this agreement was done with Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka's capital is Sri Jayawardenepuri Kotte. In which state recently was the 104th Indian Science Congress recently took place, and it was inaugurated by Prime Minister himself, Narendra Modi. 104th Indian Science Congress was recently held in Tirupati in Andhra Pradesh. It was held at Sri Venkateshwara University in Tirupati in Andhra Pradesh. William Christopher passed away recently. He was related to which field? So he was a very popular actor. So it is cinema. And William Christopher, he is known for his role in the movie MASH. Who has been appointed as the Chief Justice of Pakistan? He is the 25th Chief Justice of Pakistan. He was given the oath by Pakistan's President Mamnoon Hussain. So you should know who is Pakistan's president. Also, Pakistan's president is Mamnoon Hussain. And who has been appointed as the Chief Justice of Pakistan? It is Mr. Mian Saqib Nisar. Mia Saqib Nisar. Which state or union territory government has approved Good Samaritan policy? That is, if you see any road accident and you help that person, you take him to hospital, you will get an appreciation certificate also, and you will get 2000 rupees also. So this noble scheme has been started by which state or union territory government? It has been started by the government of Delhi, which is Aam Aadmi Party government, Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, who has been appointed as Britain's ambassador to the European Union. And this is because Sir Ivan Rogers, who was previously the Britain's ambassador to European Union, he resigned. This is very important because, you know, Britain is exiting from the European Union. That is called Brexit. That is Britain's exit from the European Union. So he will, this guy who is now selected, his name is Sir Tim Barrow, and he will be responsible to see out the Brexit because Theresa May is hastening the process of Brexit now. India ranks at which position among the countries offering the highest average annual salary to expatriates according to HSBC Expat Survey 2016? So those foreigners who work in India, they are called expatriates. So does India give them good salary or bad salary? This was decided by HSBC Expat Survey across the globe. Number one country which gives the best salary to foreigners who are working in its premises, number one country is Switzerland. So Switzerland is number one, second is Hong Kong, and third is India. So answer is third. India gives third, and India is ranked third, you know, on the countries offering the highest average annual salary to the expatriates. Our sports minister, that is the Minister of Sports with Independent Charge for Sports, Mr. Vijay Goyal, he has constituted a committee to upgrade the sports in India to, you know, encourage rural sports and all this. So for that, there is a committee being set up. Who has been made the president of the committee? It is Mr. Injeti Srinivas. And they can also put up the question in this way. Injeti Srinivas committee has been constituted for which purpose? So it is to upgrade the sports in India. Suggest improvement in the National Sports Development Code, functioning of the sports federation, etc. And Injeti Srinivas is the sports secretary of India right now. Now, India's atomic power plant company NPCIL is building four 700 megawatt pressurized heavy water reactor, which are called PHWR in short. That is total four, two states, two into two, total four. So in two states, it is building two 700 megawatt PHWRs. That is the pressurized heavy water reactor atomic power plants. Which two states are these? So these two states, one is Gujarat and one is Rajasthan. So the answer is Gujarat and Rajasthan. Gujarat Chief Minister is Vijay Rupani, BJP government. Rajasthan was Rajesh Sindhia, again BJP government. Next, with which country India has exchanged the list of nuclear installations and facilities? So this is an annual tradition. India always exchanges the list of nuclear installation and facilities with Pakistan so that there is a mutual trust and not distrust relating to nuclear issues. Akhilesh Yadav, he removed Shivpal Yadav as the Samajwadi Party's chief. So who has been appointed in the place of Shivpal Yadav? So there was a huge furor in the Samajwadi Party, which is the one of the few socialist parties in India. Akhilesh Yadav was elected as the president of the party, and now he has made Mr. Naresh Uttam in place of Shivpal Yadav as the chief. And things seem to be cooling down between his father and himself. In fact, Mulayam Yadav, as early as yesterday, he announced that Akhilesh Yadav will remain CM. So the answer is Naresh Uttam, he is a member of Legislative Council. Which Australian player, he joined Australia's coaching staff? So he was a great player. He was from Tasmania, just like Graham Gooch, and his name is, of course, one of the greatest players of all time, Ricky Ponting. He has joined Australia's coaching staff. Jason Gillespie and Justin Langer are already in Australia's coaching staff, and now Ricky Ponting has also joined. K.V. Pusa passed away recently. He was a former minister of which state? So K.V. Pusa, he was a former president of Pradesh Congress Committee, that is NPCC, that is Nagaland Pradesh Congress Committee. So he was from Nagaland, and he has also won election for the first time in 1993 as an independent candidate from the Angami Assembly constituency, Kohima district. So the answer is he was a politician from Nagaland. Pakistan's president Manmohan Hussein, he has honored which person with Nishan-e-Imtiaz? Nishan-e-Imtiaz is the honor which has been bestowed upon which person for his valuable services to the nation? And this person is the current army chief. His name is Kamar Javed Bajwa. And the highest civilian honor in Pakistan is Nishan-e-Pakistan. Just like Bharat Ratna is the highest civilian honor in India. Which state's power corporation was awarded with best performing power distribution utility in power sector by CBIP? That is Central Board of Irrigation and Power. So which state's power company, power corporation performed the best in 2016? And for that it was awarded the best performing power distribution utility. By the way, most of these power distribution companies are in heavy loss, and for that government has started UDAY scheme. So best performing power distribution is Punjab. The Supreme Court has removed which BCCI president as per the recommendations of the Loda committee because the deadlines were not met. He was not charged with corruption, but the deadlines were not kept. So he was removed, and now the Loda committee recommendation is that BCCI will directly come under the ambit of the Supreme Court. So Mr. Anurag Thakur has been removed as the president of the BCCI. Tata Sons. Tata Sons appointed which person as the chairman of Tata Power with immediate effect in place of Cyrus Mistry? So Tata Sons appointed Mr. S. Padmanabhan as the chairman of Tata Power. And Nasli Wadia, he was removed as the chairman of three of the Tata enterprises like Tata Chemical, Tata Fertilizer, etc. There were three enterprises Nasli Wadia headed. He was also removed. So Nasli Wadia, he has filed a case against Tata Sons. And Cyrus Mistry has also filed a case against Tata Sons. And Ratan Tata has filed a case against Cyrus Mistry. So this kind of mess up is going on. And Ratan Tata has accused Cyrus Mistry of leaking the professional and confidential documents, which only Tata Sons was privy to. Which country's Senate Functional Committee on Human Rights approved the Hindu Marriages Bill? So which country has approved the Hindu Marriages Bill? And according to this bill, the Hindu, you know, Hindus in this country, which are of course very few in minority, they can get their marriages registered now. And they can also apply for divorce. They can go to court in cases of separation. So this country is Pakistan. Pakistan has passed Hindu Marriages Bill. Which mobile app that was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Talkatora Stadium during Digidhan Festival became the most downloaded app on Google Play Store? So it is the Bheem app. Bheem, a very, very important app. Bharat interface. Now, one more thing, that Bheem app, there is UPI. So it is a type of improved UPI only. And the name was kept Bheem to honor Bheem Rao Ambedkar ji. So Bharat interface for money, important app. And it topped the charts on Google Play Store. French Olympic gold medalist, his name is Jean Vornet. He recently died. So he was a gold medalist in which sport? He was a gold medalist in which sport? He was an Olympic gold medalist. He was a sportsman. He used to do skiing. Skiing. And last time I had asked you a question, Luge, who is the only professional player from India? You answered right, Shiva Keshwan. Which organization directed that service charge billed by the restaurants are optional and it is up to the customers to pay it? See, lot of restaurants in India, if you go, they are charging up to 5 to 20% service charge. Very, very hefty charge. And they don't give services also. If they don't give enough service, why do you pay service charge? That is announced by Department of Consumer Affairs. So now it is in your hand. It is in the hands of consumer. Only if they like the services can they pay. They are not liable to pay the service charge. Which state is hosting the 30th International Kite Festival from January 8 to 13, 2017? You know, this question is very confusing, and I'll tell you why. Because in India, there are four International Kite Festival. That is why this question is important. So from 8th to 13th, it is in Gujarat. So answer to this question is Gujarat. But once 13 goes, that is Uttarayan. So Gujarat, you know, famous festival is Uttarayan. Now, from 8th to 13th January, it is in Gujarat. 14th and 15th January, it is in Hyderabad, Telangana International Kite Festival. Okay. Then from 16th to 17th, it is in Delhi International Kite Festival. And then from 18th to 22nd, it is in Belgaum in Karnataka. Okay, so there are four International Kite Festival, depends on the date, which date they ask. 8 to 13 it is in Gujarat, 14 to 15 it is in Hyderabad in Telangana, 16, 17 Delhi, 18, 22 Karnataka, Belgaum. So mark accordingly. In which city, Shripad Yesso Nayak, who is our Ayush Minister with independent charge, Minister of State with independent charge for Ayush. Ayush, you know, five things, Ayurveda, Unani, Homeopathy, Siddha, I keep repeating in every video, so by now you must have mastered it. So Yasso Nayak, he has inaugurated a 3-day international conference on yoga for diabetes. Where was this conference held? Yoga for diabetes. So it was held in Delhi. Which bank has tied up with Life Insurance Corporation of India, LIC, to give a boost to the micro, small and medium enterprises? Which bank is this? Just by looking at the options, you can tell. Which bank is responsible in India for micro, small and medium enterprises? It is the Small Industrial Development Bank of India, also called SIDBI. Now, please note, you remember Mudra Bank was also started by SIDBI. Mudra Bank comes under the purview of SIDBI. So SIDBI has partnered with LIC to give to make loans available for the micro, small and medium enterprises. Which state government has declared to ban the use of purse seine nets for fishing across the state to safeguard the fingerling of fish species? So I'll tell you what happens. So you know, these nets are like this, which catch fishes. Now they catch fishes, but they also catch the, you know, the larva of fish. So as a result, the larva, and we don't need the larva, we all only need the fish to eat, we don't eat the larva, but because the larva also comes along with these nets, the population of fish is decreasing at a fast pace. That is why purse seine nets are banned now by Maharashtra government. How many extra seconds were added to the Indian clock, you know, at the National Physical Laboratory on 1st January, because the atomic clock was struck at 11:59:59 the previous night. So there was a loss of 1 second, and therefore the 1 second was added the next day. So the answer is 1 second. H.S. Mahadev Prasad died recently. What was he famous as? So he was a minister in the, he was a Karnataka Corporation and Sugar Minister. He was a basically a politician. He died in Chikmagaluru district. And yeah, he represented Gundlupet constituency in Chamarajanagar district. The Union Cabinet has signed an agreement in the, you know, for cooperation in the field of agriculture and allied sector with which country? And this is an important MOU. This they will surely ask in the exam. In fact, not with one country. They have signed it with two countries, that is Kenya and Portugal. So the answer is both A and B. Portugal Premier was in India recently. He also gifted Narendra Modi with a Cristiano Ronaldo signed t-shirt, jersey. Kenya capital is Nairobi. Portugal capital is Lisbon. Kenya and Portugal have signed an agreement for mutual cooperation in the field of agriculture and allied sector. And this is important. Which government has decided to discontinue their recent 1-unit coin? And in the March 2017, they will start printing, and they will discontinue it by October 2017. 1-unit coin. Unit means whichever is the currency. Like in India, we have rupee. So it becomes 1 rupee coin. Similarly, in this country, it is Britain. And you know the currency of Britain is pound. Therefore, the government of Britain has decided to discontinue the ongoing, the, you know, incumbent pound that is there by October 2017, and to print new coins, to mint new coins, and this they will start at the end of March 2017. Now, with which border, to safeguard which border, will India build a laser wall and smart sensor will be put up also at the international border between which two countries? One is India, which country is other? And there has been a long issue of refugee infiltration, terrorism from this country. It is Bangladesh. John Berger died recently. John Berger was famous as what? So he was a Booker Prize winner for his book G. That's right. The name of the book is G. Okay. Remember, is that G for Gaurav. Okay. So, and G for Garg. So G. Now John Berger, he was a novelist. He was a Booker Prize winning American novelist. Next. Now, which two states joined the Uday scheme? Uday scheme, you know that the power distribution companies are in heavy debt, and to revive them, Uday scheme was started. So 18 states so far have joined Uday scheme. Now these two states have joined. So total number has increased to 20. Which are these two states which have joined Uday scheme recently? These two states are Assam and Telangana. Assam has a BJP government. Sarbananda Sonowal is the chief minister. Telangana, Telangana Rashtriya Samiti, Chandrasekhar Rao is the chief minister. Coca-Cola has signed an agreement or a contract or agreement with which bank? It has partnered, collaborated with which bank? Now you can pay for Coca-Cola products over 2.6 million retailers and 5,000 distributors cashless, digital. So a company of this scale requires a bank of this scale, which is of course the State Bank of India. Chairman is Arundhati Bhattacharya. With which country has India signed an agreement for cooperation and mutual assistance in custom matters? So like investigation of custom offenses, and to ensure efficient clearance of goods, that is to ensure sound import and export. India has signed an agreement with Uruguay, the capital is Montevideo. It's a South American country. There will be a Swachh Sarvekshan, which means it will be like a to check which city is how much clean. Last year it was conducted and Mysuru was the cleanest city in India. So 1 lakh every city with how many cities with over 1 lakh population will be a part of the Swachh Sarvekshan, and it will be carried out by Quality Council of India. Total 500 cities will be rated as on their cleanliness. Which country has become the first country in the world to give their unemployed citizens some money so that they can have social security, financial security, they can sustain themselves? Which country is this which is giving its unemployed people, and it has become the first country in the world to do so? It is Finland. The capital is Helsinki. Which city will have India's first bus to run on human and animal waste, like the human excreta and urine and the organic waste like your kitchen waste? It all becomes biogas. The main constituent of biogas is methane. It's an organic waste. And from this organic waste, now they are running buses. So which is India's first city where India's first bus will be run from human and animal waste, that is organic? It is Kolkata, the city of joy. In which country the 13th Chitwan Elephant Festival was held recently? This was basically to spread awareness about elephant extinction, elephant conservation, promote tourism. It was in Nepal. Chitwan National Park is in Kathmandu, Nepal. Who has been appointed as the new president of Rockefeller Foundation, one of the biggest foundations in the world? Who has been appointed as the new president? And he replaced Mr. Judith Rodin, who is the outgoing president of the Rockefeller Foundation. And not only is he the first Indian American to become the president, he is also the youngest person to become the president. He is an Indian and the name is Rajiv Shah. Which is the only Indian state which is there in the list of 12 tourist hotspots? This was in this list, ABTA, Association of British Travel Agents, Trends Report 2017. The only Indian state to be in this list, that is the 12 tourist hotspots, and it is also called God's Own Country, Kerala. Kerala, which has a CPIM, Communist Party of India, Marxist left government, Pinaray Vijayan is the chief minister. Which IT consultancy company has built something known as Internet of Things based birds platform? So if you like bird, if you like to watch birds, if you follow the footsteps of, let's say, Dr. Salim Ali, so if you like watching birds, then you can avail Internet of Birds based platform, and it will help you in identifying the bird species. This excellent step has been done by Bombay Natural History Society in association with the IT company Accenture. What is the theme for the 44th edition of the New Delhi World Book Fair? So World Book Fair is going on in New Delhi, and it is the 44th time it has been going on. It is the 44th edition because World Book Fair happens 2 times every year in New Delhi at Pragati Maidan. What is the theme this year? The theme this year is women, that is Manushi. Manushi means Manushi, that is the books written on and by women. Books written on the subject of women and by women, Manushi, that is the theme for the book fair going on. Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis, he unveiled the portrait of which social reformer in the General Assembly Hall of the Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation, that is the BMC. Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis, which social reformer's portrait was unveiled? It is the Mr. Prabho Dhankar Thakre. Which country has launched its first train, that is freight train to London? 12,000 kilometer distance it will travel in 18 days, one of the longest journeys in the world. And look how many countries will be there. There'll be some part of Russia, there'll be Kazakhstan. I mean, it's a long trip. It's a Belarus, Poland, Germany, Belgium, then France, and then finally to London. So it is through China. China has launched its first freight train to London. Chief Election Commissioner Dr. Naseem Ahmed Zaidi, he has announced the dates, elections, assembly elections, that is the elections that determine who will be the chief minister, the MLAs and all, in 5 states. So which of the following is not one of these states? So in which 5 states election are soon coming up? So Manipur, yes. Delhi, no. So Delhi is the answer. It is asking not one of them. Uttarakhand, yes. Uttar Pradesh, yes. Goa yes and Punjab yes. So Manipur, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Goa and Punjab, these are the five states which will have elections. Who recently launched Digital Unlocked? It is basically a training program for small and medium enterprises, and this has been launched in partnership with the Ministry of Information and Technology and FICCI, that is the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry. Now my third question for you today, who is our minister, cabinet minister for information and technology? That is the third question. So who recently launched Digital Unlock? This person was on a visit to India at his campus in IIT. The answer is Sundar Pichai. Fourth question, which IIT Sundar Pichai is an alumni of? That is your fourth question for today. When do we celebrate World Braille Day? See, World Braille Day is basically, Braille is a language for the visually impaired who cannot see, they can touch, feel, and with the tactile sensation they can read. That is the language Braille. It was discovered by Louis Braille, who himself was visually impaired. So the question is, when do we acknowledge the efforts of Louis Braille? It is the 4th January. Every year we celebrate the World Braille Day. Which company launched two initiatives? One is the My Business, okay, and second is Digital Unlocked. So I already told you Digital Unlocked, it is basically to give a boost to the small and medium businesses in India, and another initiative is My Business. So it is by Google. The 13th edition of National Ice Skating Championship 2017 is going on. It started on, I think, 7th of Jan, skating championship. I think it started on 5th of Jan, and 300 skaters are there. So don't think that it is skating, so there should be ice. Now artificial ice is available everywhere. So it is in Gurugram. Gurugram is hosting the 13th edition of the National Ice Skating Championship organized by the Ice Skating Association of India. Directorate General of Anti-Dumping and Allied Duty, which is called DGAD, it has imposed an anti-dumping duty on the import of which product from Bangladesh and Nepal for 5 years. So I'll tell you what it is. So Bangladesh and Nepal, they were dumping this product in the Indian market, and Indian market is already struggling with this product because Bangladesh is the leading manufacturer of this product. It is jute. In India, we have jute in West Bengal, but it's too scarce, and Bangladesh gives a heavy competition jute. So DGAD has put anti-dumping duty on Bangladesh and Nepal for jute and jute products also. RBI, the Central Bank, Reserve Bank of India, has appointed which person as the executive director replacing S. Paliwal? So who is the executive director replacing outgoing S. Paliwal? Her name is Surekha Marandi. Surekha Marandi is the new executive director of the Reserve Bank of India. Google paid its tribute. Google Doodle. Google Doodle is like they type Google with some, they paint it in a new font or anything to give tribute to someone. They also include images sometimes. So which social reformer on her 186th birth anniversary, Google dedicated its Google Doodle to? And her birthday is celebrated every year on January the 3rd. She is Savitri Bai Phule. Very, very important. Which organization has recognized the year 2017 as the International Year of Sustainable Tourism for Development? So this organization has said that development can be through tourism, and tourism beats terrorism. So 2017 is the year of tourism, sustainable tourism for development. It has been recognized as a year of sustainable tourism by United Nations. The headquarters is in New York. Who won the 2016 Mubadala World Tennis Championship? So his career is almost over because of his chronic, he's like plagued by injuries again and again. He is Rafael Nadal from Spain. But he has still done very well. He has won the 2016 Mubadala World Tennis Championship, which was held at Abu Dhabi. Bharatiya Gyanpeeth Award was given to which writer? Bharatiya Gyanpeeth gave the award which is called 2016 Bharatiya Gyanpeeth Navlekhan Award. Navlekhan means new writing. And this has been given to two people, Ghanshyam Devkumar Devansh and Shraddha. So the answer is both A and B. There is a solar power company called Azure Power. It has commissioned 150 megawatt solar power project in which state of India? Azure Power. And this is the largest solar plant by Azure Power Company. So in which place they have launched it? They have launched it in Punjab. The answer is Punjab. Which company received the final approval from the Reserve Bank of India to launch payment bank in India? Which company is this? It is Paytm by Vijay Shekhar Sharma, who is also the owner of 197 Communication. Airtel recently opened its fourth payments bank in fourth state. The first state which had Airtel Payment Bank was Rajasthan, then Andhra, then Telangana, and finally Karnataka. Karnataka became the fourth state to have Airtel Payment Bank, and India Post will open their first payment bank in Jharkhand. India's largest liquefied natural gas, that is LNG company, importer company called Petronet, it has signed an MOU with the Bangladesh's liquefied natural gas importer Petro Bangla. So together they will build a 7.5 million ton capacity natural gas project in Bangladesh. What is the outlay? What is the cost at which this project will be built? It will be built at a cost of 6500 crore rupees, which is like $950 million. Now Jovenel Moise has been elected as the president of which country? There were presidential elections in this country, and he won 55.6% of the total votes. He beat his competitor and compatriot Jude Celestin. So Jovenel Moise has been elected as the president of Haiti. Which state has launched a scheme which is called Arogya Raksha scheme? So basically, even the people who are above the poverty line, they have to pay 1200 rupees per year as the insurance premium, and they will be given the medical benefits. This scheme is started by Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh, important scheme. Which Australian cricketer, who is now no more, but he was included in the International Cricket Council's Hall of Fame? Hall of Fame is a group of elite people, elusive people who have achieved something very big in a particular field. So he has become overall the 82nd player to be inducted into the ICC Cricket Hall of Fame. His name is Arthur Morris, and he was inducted by Steve Waugh, the ex-captain of Australia. Arthur Morris, the legendary cricketer from Australia. The district administration of which city in Punjab has developed a mobile app called ECI 360, that is Election Commission of India 360. So basically this app will have in free and fair elections, transparency and accountability, and it has been launched by the district administration of Ludhiana, important town in, important city in Punjab. Forbes has named total of 600 people who are achievers, extraordinary achievers under the age of 30. How many Indian entrepreneurs are there in the list? Out of 600, Indians are 30. Which Bollywood actor has won the 4th Yash Chopra Memorial Award? 4th Yash Chopra Memorial Award, it has been given to Shah Rukh Khan in Mumbai by a jury. The 16th edition of Financial Stability and Development Council meeting was recently held in which Indian city to discuss various problems faced by the Indian economy, and it was attended by the Honorable Union Minister for Finance, Mr. Arun Jaitley, and this was to discuss about all the problems that are plaguing the Indian economy. It was recently held in New Delhi. That is the Financial Stability and Development Council meeting. In which state was India's first, India's first laser technology based advanced AVMS RTO checkpost? And it was inaugurated by the Chief Minister Vijay Rupani. He launched India's first laser technology based advanced AVMS RTO checkpost in Gujarat. Under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, Narendra Modi has declared that in rural areas, what is the number of houses that will be built in rural areas would be increased by what percent? So he said they will be increased by 1/3, that is 33%. But Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana is not doing too well. In this year, of 683,000 applications, only 32 houses are built. And so far, only 6,800 houses have been built. And the target is 5 crore houses by 2022. The North Delhi Municipal Corporation, it has renamed a road, like the road between Block A and Block B at Sector 15 in Rohini, after which Sikh Guru? His 350th birth anniversary was celebrated in Patna Sahib. His name is Guru Gobind Singh Ji, who was the founder of Khalsa Panth. Which state government has announced a new scheme? That is, financial assistance of 1000 rupees per month will be provided. If you are poor and if you are single woman, then 1000 rupees will be given to you so that you can sustain yourself. This scheme has been started by which government? This scheme has been started by the government of Telangana. The 2017 10-day event Island Tourism Festival. It is called Island Tourism Festival, which is basically to promote tourism, and it was started in which city? And it was inaugurated by the governor of this particular union territory or state, Jagdish Mukhi. So it is in Andaman and Nicobar, and it was in Port Blair, which is in South Andaman. Pravasi Bharatiya Divas, we celebrate Pravasi Bharatiya Divas because it is on this day, on 9th of January, Mahatma Gandhi returned to India from South Africa. And Pravasi Bharatiya Divas was celebrated from January 7 to January 9, and the theme was redefining engagement with the Indian diaspora. Redefining engagement with the Indian diaspora with Indian origin Portugal Prime Minister Dr. Antonio Costa. He's the Prime Minister of Portugal. He was our chief guest. So Pravasi Bharatiya Divas was held where? It was held in the capital of Karnataka, Bengaluru. The fourth Assam International 4-Day Agri-Horticulture Show. So it is to spread awareness about agriculture, teach farmers how they can double their income, teach them more crop per drop, that is, teach them better and efficient irrigation facilities. Fourth Assam International 4-Day Agriculture-Horticulture Show. It took place in which district of Assam? It took place in Guwahati. Japan is building smart cities in India. Three smart cities. It was informed by Japan's ambassador to India. He informed this that Japan is building three smart cities in India. And the India, you know, the Japanese ambassador to India is Kenji, Mr. Kenji Hiramatsu. These smart cities are Chennai, Ahmedabad, Varanasi. So the answer is all of these. India signed a protocol to amend the existing Double Taxation Avoidance Convention, DTAC, with which country? Protocol to amend, to make changes in the already existing DTAC with which country? This country is Kazakhstan. And please note that India also signed a Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement, third protocol amendment, with Singapore also. How much money would be deposited in the account of pregnant and lactating women in above 650 rural districts of India so that they can meet their medical expenses? Very, very important. This was announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi that 6,000 rupees will be paid to all the pregnant and lactating women in 650 rural districts so that they can meet their medical expenses. Which vector and actor recently passed away? He had also played a role of Gandhi. Guest appearance in Gandhi. He was a global actor. He had acted in Pakistan movie, Hollywood movies and whatnot, art movies, commercial movies. So he had also received Order of the British Empire and also Padma Shri, which is the fourth highest civilian award of India after Padam Vibhushan, Padam Bhushan and Bharat Ratna. Not in any order. Bharat Ratna is the highest, then Padam Vibhushan, then Padam Bhushan, then Padam Shri. So the actor is of course Om Puri. And Om Puri had played a small role in Gandhi movie, Gandhi, Richard Attenborough, and the role of Gandhi was played by Ben Kingsley. When do we observe Swami Vivekananda's birthday? And we observe it as the National Youth Day. So it's very, very important. Swami Vivekananda, who was an inspiration for the youth of the country, his birthday is celebrated as National Youth Day every year on January the 12th. The Prime Minister has approved for senior citizens, they will get a monthly fixed interest of 8%, a healthy 8% on their deposits of up to how much amount? For 10 years. This amount, the cap is 7.5 lakh. That is the ceiling. So up to 7.5 lakh, they will get 8% for 10 years. China has launched its longest bullet train that will cover a journey of 2,760 kilometers. And this journey will be from Kunming to Beijing. So remember that also. Kunming to Beijing, 2760 kilometer journey, China's longest bullet train journey. The name of the train is Shangri-La of the World. And it has been kept the name because Shangri-La is one of the most popular luxury resort in China. Prime Minister Modi announced that how many Kisan credit cards will be converted into RuPay card? Because RuPay card you can buy and sell through the card directly. But with Kisan credit card you can't do that. So 3 crore Kisan credit card will be converted to RuPay cards in the next 3 months. The 350th Guru Gobind Singh Ji Jayanti was celebrated on which day? So Guru Gobind Singh Ji, the 10th Sikh Guru, his birthday, 350th anniversary, was observed on the January the 5th. So the answer is January the 5th, 2017, and he was the founder of Khalsa Panth. He was born in Patna. So Patna Sahib is the Gurudwara there. Very, very important. So these were the absolute best questions from this week. If you do these, you don't need to worry. Don't need to read any magazine. Don't need to watch any other video in this world. Just watch this video 2-3 times and each and every question has been taken care of. Thank you for watching and do share